It is my pleasure to introduce our valedictorian, April Nicklaus.
While keeping in mind that there is no sure way to know where life is taking us. and its mysteries are as potentially full of the good as they are of the bad. While the insight and meanings of graduation speeches may vary, there is one element without which such a speech is incomplete. Thank yous, acknowledgments, gratitude. There are so many people, so many inspirational and hardworking teachers who have influenced the student body throughout these past years, and who deserve to be recognized for all that they have done for each and every student sitting here today. All of the teachers at Hightstown have worked hard with us and for us, bringing us motivation and passion and skills. And all of us have teachers who have meant a great deal to our success. Jesus Quesedo would like to thank Mrs. Gonzalez for helping him through his learning process since he was a freshman, and for being a great teacher. Matt Jacobson wants to thank Mr. Barro for being the most inspirational teacher he has ever had. And Chris Pereira wants to thank his two English teachers, Ms. Gloria Lee and Ms. Kudish, for helping him set and accomplish goals for himself. Eric Diamante would like to thank Mr. Wexler for introducing him to the world of philosophy, something so influential and intriguing that has easily become his favorite field of study. Roy Sosa considers himself lucky to have found inspiration a couple months freshman year in conversation with Mr. Hernandez, who offered him insight which changed his whole way of thinking. Mr. Hernandez said, "In today's world, you're going to meet people that are either going to make a positive or a negative impact in your life. You just have to choose which path you really want to take, and you have to choose what you really want in life." And as a freshman, without a clear direction or way of thinking, Mr. Hernandez's words meant a lot to him. So much so that he remembers it 4 years later as one of the most meaningful conversations he's ever had. And speaking of insight and life lessons, I would like to take a quick moment to share something of my own with you. It is about learning. We do a lot of learning every day, intentionally or not, big or small. And what I have learned and lived by throughout high school is to maximize this, to take every available opportunity you have to just know a little bit more. Learning isn't something you have to be in the classroom to do. It can happen during band rehearsals, sports practices, project green meetings, or in casual discussions with teachers, friends, or strangers. Don't underestimate the value of academics, but don't underestimate the value of everything else outside of academics either. Life is not just taking exams and doing homework. There are so many other experiences and so much knowledge outside of that which can make you a better, happier, and more successful human being. And because I enjoy academics and this speech traditionally deals with formal education, and the vast majority of us will continue on as students for another few years at least, I want to address something very important about academic learning as well. One very valuable lesson that I've learned through my school career is that the key to success is to take classes you love and seek out things which intrigue you. You may find just as much or more personal value in art class as you would in a math class, even if the way it factors into your GPA may unfairly suggest otherwise. It matters very little how the ranking system in high school or in college chooses to weigh your choices. It matters much more how much value it gives you. Don't hesitate to pursue learning for the sake of your own self-fulfillment. You may also choose to take courses to challenge yourself intellectually, and that is fantastic, but you will only truly benefit from them if you are motivated by the right things. There's been a lot of grumbling about the potential harms of teaching to the test, but much less about the equally harmful practice of learning to be great. Most, if not all of us, have had occasions where we've gone through assignments or entire classes with grades at the forefront of our minds. But if all you're worried about are grades, about the extrinsic, superficial representation of learning, then the actual learning, the intellectual excitement and personal enrichment, is taking a backseat. And in real life, professional of course, but personal as well, it does not matter one bit what grades you got. What matters is the knowledge that you carry with you, the ideas that shape who you are, and the pool of wisdom you have inside yourself to pull from at a moment's notice. As we go on our respective paths after high school, I hope we will all remember the things that we have gotten from our high school experience together. about the importance of determination, individuality, unity, and that we forget learners in grade and refocus ourselves on what matters, learning, for learning's sake.